We all have dreams, and the kind of stories that come through the dream is mostly illogical. It has no specific kind of storyline. It's very fragmented and so on. And artists have used that kind of illogical narration technique, or where there are multiple images in a framework, but the way they come together doesn't make any sense in the day-to-day sense. In the sense, in our day-to-day experience, we look for very specific logical conclusions. You know, a beginning and an end, or some kind of relationship between objects and things like that. So the surrealist who started painting dreams, Dali is one of the main artists from that group of artists who started painting the inner world. It is not the stories they are narrating is not about the outside world, not what is happening in the around them, but something that is happening within them. And the stories of the illogical image, which is a very magical, and it can be very puzzling. All these qualities come through in the surrealist paintings, and the kind of stories they are telling was never told before. In the sense, nobody thought of actually painting a dream world. Artists would always paint only what is seen or what is experienced, not what is dreamt of. So in that sense, there was a new kind of idea that came through in painting. And in Dali's painting, you will see sometimes it looks like a dark dream, you know, but sometimes it can be pleasant, but it is never logical. And Bikash Bhattacharya was one an artist from India who used that surrealist language, and he created paintings which are very puzzling. This also a sculpture where you seem to keep wondering what is happening in this connection. You would want to see them, your mind tries to put them back and then make sense out of that. And in that sense, it is very interesting how artists can really take you through a route. This is Chandranath Acharya, an artist from Bangalore. He, in earlier days, he used to do a lot of prints and paintings which talked about dreams and the kind of intricate imagery he built up, made their own stories which were irreconcilable in the common way. This is Babu Ishwar Prasad. He takes day-to-day objects, and the way he places them, the kind of lighting they get, you start wondering what is happening in the story that is being built up. In a regular story, the train would not be so small, or the sky would not just come in like that. So all those day-to-day experiences are subverted, and they start looking at the whole image in a very different way. This is again Bikash Bhattacharya's work. And the way he has built up the mood in this work is very strong. Since it's a very dark alley, and you see these people who are coming, it looks like a horror movie, but you don't know whether one should be afraid of that. And they don't have head, you just see the body. And it can also be people who are faceless. Like around us, you see so many people who you don't care for. I did one exercise with my students. They went and spoke to the people who stand in the security, or who sell maybe a cigarette and so on. They went to them, they spoke to them, they understood their stories and made. So these are invisible people to a great extent in our framework. So we started looking at them. So one can bring that kind of association here. Though they are there, but you don't see them. This is Manjunath Kamath's work. Again, very puzzling, intricate kind of imagery, but you don't really, you can't connect from one to the other. So that's a typical quality of a dream that one can see here. And also, very interestingly, he starts referring to other artists, like in other works. So you will see Ravi Varma, you will see European, parts of European painting there. So you keep looking at it, the story keeps developing, but because of so many disjunctures in the story, you can't make a continuous thread between them. That is the kind of strategy that many of the artists use in speaking this kind of language. The other kind of narrative that we see in art and also outside is that while telling a story, I can make it sound the opposite of what I am talking about. I can say good, but in the way I say it, I can make you sound very good. If I say that means it is no more a good, or I can call somebody an idiot, but still make it sound very, very warm and very intimate kind of comment. So in that similar way, artists also use sarcasm, they use irony, they use subversion while dealing with images, and they make all kinds of comments about people around them, situations around them. Gaganendra Tagore was one such artist. He was a relative of Rabindranath Tagore. So he is commenting on the priest class and how they exploit people and the kind of untouchability and his avarice for gaining wealth. We spoke about the scale and all that. No? So this is the scale difference that really, and also in the human body drawing, the proportion of the belly really brings out that sarcasm very strongly. George Grass commented on the political class, the people who are involved in military, and how they deal with things. And then again, we saw the connection with the headless people here. So only few people decide, and rest of them are like rubber stamp who just say yes, and they keep accepting. And then you also see various other like a donkey is here, which is eating up this. And so the more closely you see, all the other associations come in, and then there's a dictator being told things about. So even death is part of this team, and they're all together, and then there's a big table on which they scheme and they run things. Rajendra Kapse uses characters which look very similar. It's almost an extension of his own self-portrait. And if you see very closely at this, he's commenting on the arts system, in a sense, art ecosystem, where a work comes for a auction, and then you don't touch it with bare hands. You have to wear gloves, and then it is very reverentially brought to the thing. And the theme of that itself is also very painful. And then there is magic being performed, and all kinds of allusions he brings to the frame to comment about the art establishment itself. And his own portrait being used in all the places also makes another set of comments. This is Yi Munjun. Again, he uses his own self-portrait in all the characters, but they are always laughing. Like some of those political posters which we saw before, they are never tired, they are never sorrowful, no melancholy, nothing. They're laughing. Whatever act they're involved in, they're still laughing. So that makes it very sarcastic in that sense. Farhad Hussain comments on the high society and the people, the way they stylishly dress and the way they present themselves, the kind of selfie or the kind of group photos they take. And he brings this kind of cartoonish kind of feel to the whole figure. And they all start looking very similar also. But there is a certain amount of, naive quality to the painting also. This is a Japanese artist. And again, by using similar character in every figure that he draws, he makes a comment on the urban situation where we all start looking very similar, doing similar kind of routines, and like rushing in the morning to go to office, coming back in the evening, and you know, this idea of getting into that like a rat race. So that is the kind of in many of his works he uses similar character who is office going, and you know, maybe they all have to get into that rush hour traffic and then come back, and you will see slightly different expression, but they all look same. So it becomes a huge comment on the urban living. This is Banksy, an artist who makes graffiti on the walls, and nobody knows who he is, how he looks, and all. He is like an anonymous character, and from time to time, in very important places or very crucial places, he creates this graffiti, and then on the Twitter, on social media, people come to know that he has done that. Recently, he made a graffiti on a house, and that house was supposed to be sold, but it could not be sold anymore because it became very precious. Now here, this is a phone booth, and then next to the phone booth, he has created people who are eavesdropping. So a kind of statement about how your personal information is being, you know, ferreted and used or collected by all the other people involved in the state and in other economic groups. Rajeshwar Rao comments on the vanity sense of people. You know, this idea of using branded cloth, or you dress in certain way, you drink only certain things, and so on, and how that is projected in social media. Each act that you do, you have to take a picture and then post it, then only you have actually done it. So he comments on this kind of gestures of the society. And artists don't spare politicians. And when Trump came to power, there were many, many graffiti, many, many wall paintings and sculptures, so on, which came up criticizing him for various ways. And India also, artists have done it, but nowadays it's become difficult. And artists don't let go of other artists. They comment on them also. This kind of, when we saw the abstraction segment, we saw this American abstraction where artists use very tactile kind of paint and they create abstract painting. Roy Lichtenstein is a pop artist, and then he is commenting on the abstract expressionism. So artists use their tool in many different ways. Another important aspect is that every time you need not tell the story in a very big way, or it need not be so loud, or in very emotional situation, sometimes you just don't talk. You remain silent, stand next to the person. That is enough to convey a sense of you know, camaraderie or friendship or relationship. So artists use that kind of language where they say very less, but it is said in such a way that really says so much more than describing everything. A very simple drawing, very you know, effectively capturing the form, the action, that itself is enough than painting the whole scene. Now, people like Matisse, they capture that essential character of that body or the gesture, and that is enough. That you don't need more than that to narrate a story. Swaminathan has done many such paintings where you see these boulders floating, and he also brings allusions to this idea of a soul which is flying off and things like that, and also what shall I say, reflection between this to the other one, you know, the maker and you know, the God and the creation. So all these allusions are brought in, but the language is very, very, very simple, very minimal in that sense. Akbar Padamsi also uses similar language, where you don't see too much of detail, but Akbar Padamsi also, you know, made references to the philosophy of Advaita philosophy, and also various, you know, metaphorical kind of images he brought in. Some of the recent works of Manisha Gera Baswani speak in a very soft tone. The images are created by puncturing the paper with needles. The images themselves many times are about a positive vibe. The images are about flower or something pleasant, and in some works the images are about a vortex which can suck somebody. The contradiction between the way image is made and the content that is coming through makes one wonder about the kind of relationship we have between pain and pleasure. The Somnath war, he made a series of wound series papers casting, where he slashed the plaster slab, and that act of slashing, or the act of creating a dent there, was recorded in the paper casting. Yashwant Deshmukh also brings that kind of very minimal language to work, and a very distilled kind of images, very quiet color scheme, where you don't say too much in too many colors. In all these works, you will see a sense of quietness, a sense of speaking very softly, in very hushed voices. So that is the kind of strategy they use to bring your attention. So you have to go more closely, you have to become more sensitive to the tonal gradations and so on. This set of works are about home. She was in exile, and during the partition they lost their house and all that. So that story of exile, of story of losing the home, is narrated in her work in many, many different ways, but in very simple imagery which one can relate to, and the way they are put together, you start making more than one meaning then. Tanmay also speaks a very similar kind of language, where large areas are kept without too much of things happening, but it's very tactile. You can see a lot of texture there, very minute difference in color. Himaj Shah is a senior artist, and for a long time he has been using the language of minimal detailing. You know it's a face, you know it's a human form, but the anatomical details are not shown. But and it is referring to very different kind of emotions there. Rajendra Tikku also, he is from Kashmir, and he brings in very ordinary objects, maybe a twig, maybe a stone, and the way he brings them together, it really starts meaning more than that found object. And they are very, very simple in their approach to deal with this. A good artist is trying to use the tools at his disposal to the maximum benefit. It could be a dreamy work, or a sarcastic work, or a minimal kind of work which speaks in very low voices. But 2+2 is never 4 in an artwork, it's always more than that. If you have enjoyed watching this video, please press like button. To see more such videos, subscribe to our channel. Thank you.